We're in Venice and we're talking about the difference between fixed hybrid, this lovely bridge, and fluid hybrid, the canals around us. Last year it was all, oh no, Christine, our people are grown-ups, we let them choose when they want to come in and when they don't. And this year it's all, Christine, could you get them to come in? Like, can we move from this fluid hybrid to fixed hybrid? How do we do that? Now, I don't have any particularly easy magical solutions for you, but I do have a few things you really need to think about. The first obvious one is, what do you want them in for? Can you express that? Can you articulate it?
What I want you to do is build me a small doghouse.
One of my observations is that people don't necessarily understand their input into that collective culture building, training, development piece that many bosses and leaders seem to be striving for. And secondly, a lot of people don't actually recognize the value that they get from it necessarily. So being able to articulate that is going to be really important to you.
Friday is Hawaiian shirt day.
The next thing that you might want to consider is the fact that when we interview people who are working in a fixed hybrid model, they tend to feel much calmer and have less cognitive overload than those in a fluid hybrid model. All that decision making about what day to come in, when your boss is in, when you've got drinks out, kind of evaporates, as does the conflict potentially within your household if someone else is in a fluid hybrid over who gets precedent over which days. So a fixed hybrid model can be easier for people individually to work. It also takes away the discretionary spend of travel. If people aren't sure whether they need to go in or not, they tend to err towards, why would I spend 20 quid on my train ticket? If I'm not sure I need to be in, I'll just stay at home. If they know what days they need to go in, then that money has psychologically already been spent, and so they're more relaxed about it. The final thing I would urge you to consider is the AWA data. They looked at big organisations across Europe rather than small ones. They found an average of 1.3 days that people were coming in, but what they noted was not a huge number of difference between those who were on a fixed hybrid plan and those who were on a fluid hybrid plan, which means actually changing the policy might be leading you in the right direction, but you may still have to think about what you're going to do to actually make it work in practice. Good luck with that. Next week, we're going to be talking about those heating bills, whether it's going to drive people into offices, and how it might correlate to the frenzy of the rush for the air conditioning last summer. See you then. Just one cornetto.